Stay away. It's not safe here.
I'm glad you're here. I've been trying to help these poor people, but it's futile. There's a blight here that's turned them into rabid beasts. These Bosma may be beyond aid, but we must find a way to stop the blight from spreading. Undoubtedly, it's the corruption of Prince Naaman's shade, spreading through the forest and somehow affecting the people here. The blight emanates from the trees, which may... I'm glad you're here. Undoubtedly, it's the corruption of Prince Naaman's shade, spreading through the forest and somehow affecting the people here. The blight emanates from the trees, which may offer us an opportunity to at least contain it using the Standing Stones. Long ago, before the Green Pact, the Standing Stones were used to protect the people from the aggression of the forest. If we can activate the stones, it could prevent the trees from spreading the blight to anyone else. We must work quickly, my friend. Clearly, the blight doesn't affect all Bosma, but if anyone wanders into this area, I suspect there is a strong chance they will become afflicted. If we forbid a scouting party of Vinedusk Rangers comes here. I can't be sure, but I suspect it's our people's connection to the Green that allows us to be infected. other races will be immune. It also seems that some Bosma can resist the Blight. For that, I have no explanation whatsoever. Even the water here seems to be somehow tainted. I can actually sense the Blight attempting to corrupt my mind. I've never felt anything like this. Corruption has spread to these plants as well. It's like they're dead, but not dead at the same time. Ifris bodes. The corruption is coming from the Den of the Eldest. We need to get there, quickly. If the Eldest has been corrupted, then everything in this area, every plant, every creature, and every person will soon become corrupted as well. I can't imagine how this Blight can so easily penetrate the forest's protections. It is an ancient plant, a strangler. It's been here from the beginning. It's the lifeblood of the forest in this area. If the Eldest is truly tainted, then regardless of the Green Pact, we must slay it. I don't think so. We must consider the significance of the Green Pact as a whole. At its core, it's a covenant in which we protect the Green and the Green protects us. In this case, we must cut off the limb to save the trunk. It's the only way. Not without assistance. After we've killed it, you must remove its heart. We may be able to use that to grow a new strangler to take the Eldest's place. Yeah.
can destroy the Eldest, but you cannot have the Prophet. It belongs here in the Shadowwood. You will bring it to me.
And we find ourselves here once again. It's so unnatural. It makes me feel queasy. The Eldest's heart must be the nexus that ties this plane to ours. I suspect it is also tethered to Naaman's servant, the one who addressed us. We have no choice, though it sounds as if we risk handling the Eldest's heart back over to the enemy. Perhaps, though, we might also purge more of the Blight while we were in this realm. That might help us both here and there. The trees in the forest. The taint came from the Eldest, but it has undoubtedly spread to the spirits of the trees themselves. If we can slay the corrupted tree spirits, more of the forest may be spared. The Eldest's heart can help us. The heart's energy could help you slay the tree spirits, but I'm actually not sure that would be a good idea. If we use the heart this way, it will be corrupted. It would destroy any chance of using it to grow a replacement for the Eldest. Very well. I'm not sure this is the best course, but I am biased by my attachment to the Green. I trust your judgment. The heart's energy will accompany you to destroy the corrupted tree spirits. Find me when you're done.
To a merciful death. Maybe. Your hopeless heroism ends here.
At least it's over now. We stopped the blight from spreading and defeated Naaman's servant, but at such cost. I worry about our decision to sacrifice the eldest's heart. Its absence will be felt, and without a replacement, well, I don't know. Thankfully, your efforts within the Shadowwood saved many of them. But there is still much corruption in the forest. I can feel it. Our work is far from finished. Here, I'll take the heart now. May the green bring our paths together once more, friend. Their rage has subsided, but they remain touched by the corruption. They will never be themselves again. But we can care for them and give them comfort. It is the least of our duty.
You bring me business. Auriel, grant me strength. I hope you're the one Indania spoke of. Thank the Eight. The army here is greater than we anticipated. Damn these gates. Damn the corruption. I should be in there, not Indania. He said you'll be able to pass through. Help him. Stop Naaman. He wasn't wrong. The Veiled Heritance subjected my brother's body to an unnatural resurrection as a lich. He has the Staff of Magnus and is using it to suppress Hectorhaim's necromantic wards and raise an undead army. Very. According to Indania, Hectorhaim guards the heart of Valenwood. He believes Naaman is corrupting it, and this corruption turns any soldiers we send forth feral. Indania knows more. He waits for you at the gate. Indania believes he can enter unharmed, and you as well. I pray he's right. We have only limited understanding of the history. Sometime after the passing of the Aeliads, a necromancer or group of necromancers tried to raise an army of the dead. Necromantic wards were put in place, but now Naaman is suppressing them. Even as a lich, I don't believe Naaman is powerful enough to disrupt the ancient wards. Elendari believes it's the Staff of Magnus. We must retrieve the staff and secure it for the Aldmeri Dominion. Some say it once belonged to Magnus, the god of magic himself. Some say it was a gift. Others say it was stolen. Others believe it's a test. It suppresses magic, and it seems Naaman is using it to subdue the wards. I little understand it, but the Bosma have described it to me as the center of Greenshade. As Naaman is allowed to corrupt it, the forest will die. The Bosma here would lose their homes and be forced to flee.
An egg brother betrays his people in Silent Mire. Sithis take him for doing such a thing.
For.
Yeah!
I can assure with every confidence our vaults will never be breached, and I should know as a reformed robber of banks.
Thank you. Thank you.